Hello, my name is Colin Ransom, and today I'm here to talk to you about a problem us as the human race face in our day-to-day lives, and that is the abundance of unrecycled fishing nets floating around in the ocean. This is a problem because animals cannot successfully live in their natural habitat, such as a seal, who cannot escape this net of fishing nets that he's tangled in. Each year, around 300,000 whales, dolphins, and other porpoises die from entanglement in fishing nets. This is a problem because this destroys our biodiversity in the ocean. Biodiversity is important because species tend to keep other species in check and also other species alive. And without species, such as some of these, which are keystone species, our environments that we live in would severely depreciate, and we would soon be living in a world where the ocean might be empty. Other endangered species that suffer from this problem are especially the sea turtles, and they often get tangled in these nets when trying to lay eggs on the shore or just living their day-to-day lives. Around 10% of all pollution in the ocean is from fishing nets. And this is a big problem, as 10% is a substantial number. And so if we work together to fix this problem, maybe we can live in a better space that everyone in the ocean and out of the ocean will be healthier as an ecosystem and as a community. So, ways we can do this. Fishing nets are essentially just plastic, like that's woven into a net form. So companies such as Econol, they take these fishing nets, they source them from the oceans, and they take them down to their plants, and they turn this fishing nets into a plastic thread, similar to nylon, which can be weaved into other products, such as bottles, clothes, and just fabric. All these are very versatile materials that we can turn into day-to-day products that we can always use. For example, Adidas has worked together with this company and other companies to take fishing nets directly out of the ocean and turn them into shoes. This shows how you as a people can all help to get fishing nets out of the ocean by supporting these companies and supporting brands that use these materials to be eco-friendly and get these fishing nets out of the ocean. This is Kelly Slater. He's an 11-time World Surfing Champion, currently the oldest surfer on tour, and he has a lot of experience in the ocean. He has worked his whole entire life there and spends probably more life on water than he does on land. So now we know that he has a ton of experience. He is going to work with other companies to develop a clothing line which uses fishing nets as its main material. His clothing line is called Outer Known, and they use these fishing nets to make, and with Econol, they use the fabric and the thread from Econol to turn them into these clothes that everyday people can wear. This is him sitting atop the fishing nets that he's going to use to source from, to make his clothes. And these fishing nets came from fisheries in Portugal, and so they turn these into the fabric, which can be then turned into clothes. So, here we have ocean. These are the pollutants in the ocean, and you can see that 31.67% is fishing debris. So if you can remove these fishing debris from the ocean will be 31.67% cleaner. And so imagine how much of an effect this can have on the ocean in which we live. Other ways to support companies that support this is Burio Skateboards. They're a Chilean company. And they take fishing nets from Chilean fishermen and melt them down and turn them into skateboards. As an incentive for the fishermen, they'll get 15 cents a net if they bring it in. And around each net, you get one skateboard. So that way, the fishermen have an incentive to turn their nets in instead of just leaving them floating around the ocean. So every board equals, this is 30 square feet of fishing net. And so every skateboard that someone buys or uses will get rid of this much pollution from the ocean. And they're slowly starting to branch out into other products besides skateboards, such as sunglasses and other products. This is how they do it. They take the fishing nets here from the Chilean coastline, they shred them into pellets, and then melt them down into the decks for their skateboards. So how can you help? You can help by supporting these companies which support fishing nets. By buying more of these clothes and other products that use fishing nets, you can slowly work towards the big goal of having a totally closed unit of production. What this means is that the fishing nets will be used to make the clothes, but these clothes will then not be thrown away into landfills, but then will be recycled again to make more clothes. Therefore, we won't need to source any new products and ever throw back into the world in which we live. And then these are my sources, where I got most of my information from. And thank you very much.